woke up this morning, David told me the other night, when I talked to him, he says, well, I'm gonna do this little thing for Pa, and hopefully other people will join in and do something, and I thought, gosh, Marilyn, what are you gonna do? I was up at 5 o'clock this morning, to make my salad, that's normal time for me. And, so anyway, inspiration hit, I thought, oh, I'm just gonna jot down some little things, and it came together at home. When Pete would tell us stories, I'd take notes. So some of this is his words. So then, this was one of the items that we would shop for at Albertson's, 60 cookies for $1.90. Behold, I went to Albertson's today, and they were on sale for $1.75.
They went down.
So, take a cookie, and get a tribute to Uncle Pete. Here's to Uncle Petey, the last in line to go. Number 6 of 7 Latin children, he wasn't much for show. As a boy with his team of horses, looking for some hay, he plowed the neighbor's gardens. McPherson paid $1 for a 13-hour day. With Cousin Briggs, Pete, nothing to the bear, indulging in childhood play, he ate fair food, got real sick because, quote, the food wasn't like today. Uncle Pete, as Steve would call him, no longer able to roam, spotted my mom and daddy at the fair. Mom said, you're too sick to stay here, we're taking you home. Uncle Pete served in the Air Force in Alaska. Was it close to Nome? Still remembering the exact date and time he boarded his flight for home. Pete's sense of humor was the best, with the giving of his horse to an excited Bernese who rushed to find the steed quite dead. The Latins raised and butchered goats as life was poor and times were hard. Earl Latin hated those goat meat sandwiches, no doubt slathered up with lard. The quote, real springy sandwiches were traded to some unsuspecting kid at school. When it came to food that tasted good, Earl Latin's palate ruled. Pete loved Sherry, David, Loretta, Frisky, Tinker, and too many pets to recall. Then there was Bar S, Bologna, Grandma Latin cookies, 12 packs of Diet Pepsi on sale, Crispy Treats, and bingo, not least of all. While living with David and Loretta and avoiding nursing home strife, over the phone, Uncle Pete told me, this is the happiest time of my life.
Oh.
So let's raise your cookies in celebration of Earl Latin. Ernie named him Pete. Take a big cookie monster bite and know he was the sweetest of the sweet.
So, David, what was the story on that Orpha Holmgren?
Oh, here, here it is.
Was it split up between the survivors that were left, or?
It was split up between 12 people. And I do not know rhyme or reason why, who those people are. Most of them were, you know, Minnesotans and relatives of Orphas. Or who knows what.
Because that would have been her husband's side of the family, not hers.
Yeah.
He would have been.
That's just it. There was really never any reason why she thought of him.